Welcome back students. Today we'll see another topic of nutrition in animals, that is chapter 2 part 3 biology for class 7. In previous video we have seen the nutrition in animals, in which we learned the ingestion process. Today we'll start digestion. Digestion in human beings is a start itself in the mouth. To learn this process in the mouth, we should learn various parts of the mouth. So the various parts of the mouth are sets of teeth, tongue, and various salivary gland. These salivary glands are parotid gland, sublingual gland, and submandibular gland. So inside our mouth, the food is first broken down into the small pieces with the help of our teeth, and the salivary glands produces saliva that contains some digestive enzyme which helps in the digestion or the breaking down of starch into the simple sugar. And this saliva makes the food soft and easy to swallow. Then once the digestion is started in the mouth, then the food is passes into a long tube called food pipe or esophagus. This food pipe starts from the end of the mouth and ends at the top of the stomach, or we can say this food pipe runs along the neck and the chest, right? So the wall of the food pipe or the esophagus produce some special type of movement or special wave-like movement. This movement is called peristalsis movement. This movement helps to push the food forward towards the stomach, right? And also this movement takes place throughout the alimentary canal, which pushes the food in the downward direction. The stomach. Stomach is a thick-walled, J-shaped muscular bag, and the wall of the stomach secrete the digestive juices, mucous membrane, and hydrochloric acid. And what is the function of this hydrochloric acid and mucous membrane? See, we know that the digestive juices helps in digestion, and also this hydrochloric acid present inside the stomach helps to kill the bacteria that enters with the food, right? And that mucous membrane protects the wall of stomach from this concentrated hydrochloric acid. So the digestive juices, which is present inside the stomach, helps in breaking down the complex protein into the simple substance. But in this stomach, the digestion is not yet completed. So the partial digested food is called the chyme and is need to be passed forward towards the small intestine for further digestion. Now the small intestine. The digestion of the food is completed in the small intestine. Right, so the small intestine intestine is highly coiled, and it is longest part of the alimentary canal. It is about 7 to 5 meter long. It receives the secretion from two different organs or gland, that is liver and pancreas, and it also secretes its own juice for the digestion. So here we are talking about the top part of the small intestine. So various organs that attach to the small intestine are liver. First is liver. So liver is a reddish brown organ that produces a juice called bile juice, which store the bile juice in a sac like structure called gallbladder. Right? So this bile juice, which is secreted by the liver and is stored in the gallbladder, helps in the digestion of fat. In same way, the leaf like structure located just below the stomach produces the juice called pancreatic juice, and this pancreatic juice act on the carbohydrate, fats, and proteins and convert into the simpler form. Here the carbohydrate is converted into simple sugar like glucose, fats is converted into the fatty acid and glycerol, and protein is converted into amino acids. The wall of a small intestine produces this intestinal juice that completes all the digestion itself in the small intestine. After digestion, absorption of the nutrients takes place. So the absorption of the nutrients takes place in the small intestine. If you see inside the small intestine, there has a numerous tiny finger-like projection called villi. So this villi is increase the surface area of the small intestine about 5 times, right? And if you see inside this villi, there is a network of blood vessels which absorbs the nutrients and carry or transport to the various parts of the body. The large intestine. Large intestine is followed by small intestine. So the large intestine is wider, shorter, and it is about 1.5 meter long. In the small intestine, the absorption of the nutrients takes place, but in the large intestine, it absorbs water and salts from the undigested food. During the digestion, the minerals and vitamins do not change their properties and they need to be absorbed as they are. So here we can see the structure of large intestine. It starts where the small intestine ends. Assimilation. So assimilation, the absorbed nutrients are transported into the different organs of the body where they are utilized for different activities. So this is the assimilation. And what are these activities? So once the glucose and oxygen enters in the cell, it is broken down and convert into the carbon dioxide, water, and release lots of energy. And this process is called cellular respiration, by which the organism gets their energy. And the excess of glucose is stored in the cell of liver as a glycogen. And also the amino acids. We know that amino acids are formed because of the breaking down of protein, and the protein we called as the building block of the element. So here in the same way, the amino acids build the new living materials of the cell. And fatty acids and glycerol are stored under the layer of the skin as a energy reserve. Digestion. The undigested and unabsorbed food enter into the large intestine, where the water present in it is absorbed. And the waste is now become solid and is stored in the last part of the large intestine, which is called rectum. And with due time, the waste is removed out of the body. Now we learn about digestion of food in ruminants. So what are these ruminants? The grass-eating animals like cow, buffalo, horses, sheep, goat, etc., they can bring the swallowed food back into their mouth and chew it again. These are called ruminants, and the process is called rumination or chewing of cud. So the grass is having the specific type of carbohydrate that is called cellulose, which is not easy to digest. So the rumination helps this animal to digest the specific carbohydrate like cellulose, which is present in the grass or fodder. So the stomach of the ruminant has the 4 chamber, that is rumen, reticulum, omasum, and abomasum. So here the ruminants quickly swallow the plant matter or a grass without much chewing, and which is mixed with saliva, and half of the chewed food is now transferred into the largest chamber of the stomach, that is called the rumen. Here the food in the rumen, the food is partially digested by the bacteria present in the saliva as well as the bacteria present inside the rumen. So the partially digested food in the rumen is now called curd, and this curd is now passed to the next chamber, that is called reticulum. And when this ruminants sit and relax, the curd from the reticulum come back to the mouth into the small lumps for thorough chewing. So the completely chewed food into the mouth is swallowed again and directly reaches to the omasum. It is a 3rd chamber where the completely chewed food is reached, where the water from the food is absorbed. Now the food is pushed to the next chamber, that is called abomasum, which is called the true stomach of the ruminants, and the food is then sent to the small intestine, where the and absorption of food takes place. And in the ruminants, there is a special sac that is lies between the junction of small intestine and large intestine called cecum, where the digestion of the cellulose takes place. Then the undigested food is passed on to the large intestine, and this large intestine absorbs water from the undigested food, and the remaining solid waste are ingested out of the body through anus. And human cannot digest cellulose because cecum is non-functional, so that is why cellulose fiber in our food are ingested out. Thank you. So we have finished the chapter, that is nutrition in animal. We'll meet again with a new chapter. Till then, take care. Goodbye.